Creating powerful 3D designs is not enough to manufacture a die. No, you need powerful 2D still as well. Here, you can see through some powerful automation, we're automatically creating the views you need to manufacture your die. Here you see the strip view. It's showing you where the punches are happening, where the bend operations are happening. Maybe we also want to include all the force notes. Why not? We'll position like that, and they propagate. Next, maybe we want to generate a drawing of one of the plates. So here, maybe we'll specify some specific colors, and we'll project that plan view, and then maybe a side view as well. From there, let's go ahead and maybe position this view a little bit better. And now, we're going to go ahead and add some drilling dimensions. Are you ready for this? It is one click simple. And like that, all the drilling dimensions are done. Next, maybe we want to add a drilling table. So we'll go to drill table, we'll choose our template, we'll choose our view, as well as set our Z depth by choosing an edge on the side view, and then we'll choose the location of this table. Like that, our table's done. You can see all the great information is given to you automatically there, and all the labels are on the part. Maybe, though, you want to add some specific drilling notes. We can do that for you automatically, too. Just go to drilling note, select the drilling, and we automatically create the proper note for you based on the type of drilling defined in the 3D model. Here, for example, we selected a tapped hole, and as you can see, you get the tapping information given in that note. Very cool. Now, how about we make the drawing for the entire assembly? Here, we're going to make some quick setting changes here, and then we're going to project the main assembly view. Let's locate it right down there. Now, let's maybe make some auxiliary views. I want to generate maybe a front view of my entire die. We'll put it right there. How about we do that one more time to create a side view? Perfect. Now, how about we create a section view? We can either do a full section or a section, and that just is a level of detail. And now we're going to make a horizontal cutting curve. Here we can see section B is created. We can choose which direction we want to look at it, say OK, and TopSolid does the heavy lifting for you, and it automatically generates that section view for you. Let's put it over here on this view. Like that, we have a couple of main sections. Let's do another one. Let's say we want a more detailed section view. How about one that steps through our assembly? So here, if we pick on any circular object, we can just start creating dynamically the section curve where we want to cut through this assembly. So here we started at the pin. Now we're going up through that screw. Now we're going to pass through this. And let's maybe come down through this screw. And then finally, we'll pass through this leader pin here. Like that, we'll say stop. Again, we'll choose the direction we want that section to be looking, and then just simply choose a location to put it. I mean, how easy is this? Finally, no design is complete without a bill of material. And don't worry, we'll do that for you too. So here, we're going to go to our bill of material functions. In this case, we're going to browse and choose a user-defined bill of material. We're going to choose the drawing to place it on. We'll choose the location. And like that, TopSolid does the rest.